Good evening, everyone. And okay, so welcome all of you, and thank you all for joining us for today's session. And we will all be talking about MBBS abroad. Okay, about which university to choose, how to go about it, how the process works. We will be knowing each and every detail. Okay, so coming to the questions, the first question is by Savan Yadav. How is Jiangxi University of TCM in India, in China? Sorry. Okay, so let me make one thing clear. Okay, when you are thinking about MBBS abroad, please make sure that you are choosing a university which is 100% English medium. Okay, 95% of the universities in all these countries, Russia hai, China hai, Ukraine hai, Georgia hai, ye sab jagah pe 95% programs jo hai wo bilingual hote hai. Okay, bilingual meaning 3 years in English, the first 3 years, and 3 years in their language, which is in Russian or Ukrainian. Okay, now if an Indian student is taught for 3 years in Russian or Ukrainian, he is definitely not going to clear his MCI screening test. Okay, forget MCI screening test, it's going to be difficult for him to even clear his MBBS. Okay, so I'm going to show you a government report. Okay, if you go on the Indian embassy in Russia, okay, if you're going in the education section, okay, and if you go to annexure, performance of candidates in the screening test conducted by NBE, there is an entire report given by the Indian embassy in Russia. It is published by the MCI. Okay, so this report definitely cannot lie, cannot misguide. Okay, now ye report aapko batata hai जिस कंट्री में, जिस जिस यूनिवर्सिटी में इंडियन स्टूडेंट जाते हैं, उनका एमसीआई पासिंग रेशियो क्या है. वंस यू हैव स्टडीड योर एमबीबीएस अब्रॉड, यू विल हैव टू अपियर फॉर एन एमसीआई स्क्रीनिंग टेस्ट विच विल नाउ बी नोन एज नेक्स्ट. ओके, सो दैट रेशियो इज गिवन ओवर हियर. वर्ल्ड रैंकिंग इज नॉट समथिंग यू नीड टू लुक एट व्हेन इट कम्स टू एमबीबीएस. ओके, yes, so coming back, so we can go country by country. Okay, MCI has approved a lot of colleges abroad, but not all of them necessarily have a good quality of education. Okay, and because there are so many options, there are a lot of agents, there are a lot of these small consultancies, lot of people, you know, lot of ex-students even, who misguide the students into the wrong universities just because it is approved by MCI. And because of that, a lot of students were placed in bilingual universities, low quality universities, and because of that, students were not able to pass MCI. Okay, now that created a problem. So that's the reason the Indian embassy in Russia, the MCI, published a report to make it clear which university belongs to the A grade section, which to the B grade, and which to the C grade. Okay, now I'm sure this report will answer most of your questions, because usually I get questions from students saying which university is the best, which country is the best, whereas there is no country which is the best. It is the university which might be belonging to an A grade section, some to the B grade, and some to the C grade. Okay, so now looking at Russia, okay, the first university we leave, okay, because there is only one student appeared and one has passed. That's the reason it has 100%. Okay, next one is Crimea State Medical University. It has a passing ratio of 38.7, which is approximately 40%. So, ye report jo hai aapko do cheeze batayega. Okay, one is the quality of education in that university, and second, the medium of teaching. Okay. Now, you just, if you apply a simple logic, the embassy has made it very, very clear to all of us, okay, that if an Indian student is taught for 3 years in English and 3 years in Russian, he cannot get, that university cannot have such a high MCI passing ratio. Okay, so as you keep going down, the MCI passing ratio is keep decreasing. Okay, so universities which are above 20%, they are considered to be in the A grade section. Okay, universities which are 20% and below are B grade, and which are below even 16-15%, they are completely C grade. There are also universities with 0% ratio. Okay, so please beware about this, because sabse zyada wahan pe bilingual program chalte hain, and if you get into a bilingual program, your career is not going anywhere. Okay, and it's not just about doing your MBBS, it is also about your PG, because MBBS is the foundation, okay, that you are going to set. The real takeoff of your career is going to happen after MBBS. So agar aapne foundation sahi se nahi dala hai, so PG milna bhi aapko bahut mushkil hoga. So make sure that any university that you choose for MBBS, it is a government university, point number one. It is a 100% English medium university, point number two. And it is a university which does not come in, you know, the war zone or a disturbance area or anything like that. Okay. Now, there are some countries which have a problem, like say Georgia or Philippines, which are too promoted in India, okay, by a lot of people, for the wrong reasons. So if anybody who wants to know about Georgia or Philippines, please go to what the Indian embassy wants to talk about it. Okay, there are there can be a relative, there can be a friend, there can be an agent who is misguiding you. So make sure ki aap jo source ko trust kar rahe ho wo sirf aur sirf ek government source hai. Okay, like the report is a government source. Okay, the advisory by the embassy is a government source, correct? So make sure you're focusing on such sources. So coming back to the questions, Savan, as you asked me, TCM in China basically means traditional Chinese medicine. Now this is not even a bilingual program. This is a 100% Chinese medium program. Okay. Now allopathy in China started in 2002. Okay, before that there was only traditional Chinese medicine, and now TCM is only known in China. It is not known in other parts of the world. So I mean, if you want to study your 6 years of MBBS in Chinese language, which is the most difficult language, then you can go for it, but it's completely the wrong choice for you. Go for an English medium program in China in a better graded university, Savan. Okay, next question, Ravi Yadav. How can we trust with fee that it will not change? Now universities will give you give a cost sheet. Okay, it is also there on the website, and if you go to a trusted consultancy, they will also provide you that. Okay, now the cost sheet, you need to make sure, there are a lot of consultancies, a lot of agents who, you know, play around with the cost sheet as well. So make sure that that's not what's happening with you in the first place. Secondly, wo jo cost sheet hoti hai, it is revised every year. So for example, if you're going in the 2018 batch, they will be telling you the fee structure for right up to 6 years for your batch. So that is not going to change, but the fee structure might change for the 2019 batch. Correct? So that's not something you need to worry about, Ravi Yadav, until or unless you're going to a wrong consultant. Okay. Harris Mustafa, what is the difference in MBBS in Philippines and Russia? Harris, Russia gives you direct admission into MBBS. For the reason why you're going is to become a doctor, to directly do MBBS. Whereas Philippines is not going to give you direct admission. It first takes you to BS. Okay, now you have to do BS for 2 years, then appear for an exam called NMAT. Now NMAT is the NEET of Philippines. The local students of Philippines also appear for the exam. They have a lot of reservations, limited capacity, limited bandwidth. Okay, now and after 2 years, if you do not crack NMAT, you are sent back. So basically it's a big risk that you take, Because there will always be people who will be telling you, okay, I have passed in NMAT, there's no problem, you also come in. But the reality is, it's not necessary that if he has passed, you will also pass. Because there are 800 students going to Philippines every year and 600 students are sent back. There are only 200 who get in. So 80% students are sent back because they do not crack NMAT, and they come to know about this after 2 years, which they are not aware of. The consultancies or the agents do not make them aware about it. Also, the hostels and the campus of the universities in Philippines, they have a very limited bandwidth. Okay, if they have a bandwidth of say 20 students, there are 80 to 100 students who are, you know, filled in. It's a commotion, it's a crowd. Okay, it's not a comfortable atmosphere for you to study. So please make sure that you're choosing the right place, because you have to be there for 6 years and it's not a small time. Okay, so Harris, there's a huge difference between Philippines and Russia. I hope this made sense to you. Okay, besides this, Harris, I would like to take you to one more place. You go to the Indian Embassy in Philippines, Indian Student Advisory. The Indian Embassy in Philippines has given an entire advisory of what problems happen. So please make sure that, you know, you're reading this. You can read from here. As of now, the feedback from students, mostly private schools in partnership with educational agents, enroll more students in the BS course, sometimes in excess of 4 to 5 times over their capacity. In other words, if a medical school has a capacity of inducing 200 seats, they enroll roughly about 800 in the BS course. How will they accommodate the extra students when they do not have the capacity to do that? Okay. So this is what the embassy is writing. It is not what any normal person is saying. Okay. And so this is a completely trustworthy source. We can trust on it. So Philippines is a completely wrong choice. For students who are thinking about it, please do rethink your decision, because you might have a bad time after going there. So please, please beware and take the right decision. Okay. Okay. Next question. Can we do internship in India after MBBS in Russia? No, you cannot, Ravi. You have to do your internship in Russia. And after coming back to India, you have to do another internship. It's only in China that to some universities which give you that flexibility of doing 5 years over there and then 1 year of internship in India. But as far as Russia is concerned, you have to, not only Russia, but all the good graded universities, there is a rule in the Eastern European countries that you have to do 5 years of MBBS plus 8 months of internship. Okay, otherwise it is not considered valid in most part of the world. So Georgia, most of the degrees from the universities in Georgia are not valid in the rest of the world. Okay, simply because they have private universities giving 5 year degrees. So be careful. Okay, next question is by Jyoti Chauhan. Will the studies be completely in English for 5-6 years, or half English and half in their local language? Jyoti, that's exactly what I was explaining. I hope my explanation gave you your answer. Okay, there are universities which have 100% English medium. There are universities which have bilingual programs, that is half and half. And there are universities which have 100% local, I mean their Russian or Chinese language program. So make sure you're going to a university with 100% English medium program only. Otherwise, you are in trouble. Okay. And it's only the good top universities which have a ratio of above 20% which will be able to give you that. Okay. Otherwise, they will all be bilingual. Next question. Will each university prepare for MCI test from students in Russia? Rutuja, no university will prepare you because you're going to a university in Russia. It is approved by MCI, but they have nothing to do whether, I mean, they are not going to take extra efforts to prepare you for MCI. Okay, and MCI screening test is a very difficult exam, and until and unless you prepare for it for all 5 years of your MBBS, you are not going to crack it. So make sure you are carrying MCI preparation along with you. Okay, we have online MCI coaching available, so you can take that along with you. Little by little, prepare for it every day, and by the end of the sixth year, you'll be completely prepared for your MCI exam. Okay. So do not depend on any university. If you're going to the good universities, it's a bonus for you because they already have a good quality education. But you cannot pass MCI only dependent upon a university's education. So carry preparation with you. Okay. Next question. How the university is going to support the screening test in India? As that's what I told you. The universities are approved by MCI, but you have to carry preparation with you. What is the best option to study MBBS Russia or Ukraine? It's not about the country, it is always about the university. Even if you go to US and you go to the wrong university, it absolutely makes no sense. Okay, so go to the right university, go to the right country. Both are equally important. Okay, now if you're going for Russia, go to Crimea, go to Ryazan, go to Dagestan, go to the top ones which have a good ratio. If you're going to Ukraine, go to universities like Lviv. Lviv is closed though now. Go to university like Vinnytsia. Do not choose the lower grade universities, okay? Because those universities will be open right till August because they do not have enough students. So make sure you up universities choose kar rahe ho. They are all above 20% ratio. They have good quality education, fully English medium. Everything is right. Okay. What is the procedure regarding MBBS in Philippines? Prathamesh, I'm sure you will rethink your decision about Philippines after listening to this and after reading the advisory by the Indian Embassy. Okay. What about Bogomolets National Medical University? There is nothing positive or negative. It is basically a lower grade university. Okay. Now, if you do not get into the higher grade university, this is the option that you have. If we go back to the report, and if we go for example, if we go to the Ukraine section. Okay. So there are all the countries available, all countries, all universities. Kazakhstan, there's Kyrgyzstan, Georgia, Moldova, Latvia, Lithuania, Tajikistan, Ukraine. Okay, coming to Ukraine. Now leaving the first two because there are very less students appearing. Okay, if you go to number, now Ukraine, the eastern part of Ukraine has a little bit of disturbance. So, for example, agar koi student India mein padhne aa raha hai, toh wo but natural hai, he will not go to Kashmir to study, knowing the kind of disturbance that exists. So, I mean, if you're studying in, say, Mumbai or Delhi or MP or, you know, any other part of India, there's absolutely no problem. So, similarly, in Ukraine, always choose a university on the western side of Ukraine because they have a better atmosphere, a more European culture, no problem, better universities. So looking at this report, leaving the first two because there are very less students up here, third one is Bukovanian. Bukovanian comes in the eastern side. Okay, so there's no problem with the university, it has a very good ratio, but unfortunately because of its location, it has safety issues. Okay, the next one is Lviv National Medical. Now, Lviv is basically a 250-year-old university on the border of Poland, okay? So, it's completely on the western side. It is approximately 2 to 3 hours away from Germany. It has maximum Indian students going there. It has Indian food available, amazing faculty. Everything's very good about it, okay? It's a tourist destination for most of the Europeans. So, I mean, you really enjoy studying there. But unfortunately, all the seats for Lviv are over. Everybody has taken it up. It's almost closed now. So, Lviv is unfortunately not an option anymore. Those who have got it are lucky. Otherwise, you need to go for the next option, which is Vinnytsia. So, we basically need to follow this report. So, when Lviv is over, you choose Vinnytsia. The day Vinnytsia is over, you go for Donetsk. I mean, you go as per the report, because that's what the reality is. So Vinnytsia is open for the next week, 1 week, okay, and then Vinnytsia would also be shutting. So right now, all of you are actually fighting against time, okay, because if you research, you would know that all the good universities are all closed. Some are closed, some are on the closing stage. So it's very important to take your decision at the right time, because otherwise, I mean, you're going to spend money, you're going to spend 6 years, but you will not end up at the best possible place. So, any of you who are very serious about actually going for MBBS abroad, book your seat immediately, because you're losing on good universities every day. There's one good university shutting every day in this week. So, take that decision rightly, okay? Ravi, yes, somebody wanted to see. Yeah, so if you look at Bogomolets, the ratio is hardly 15.3%, which is pretty low. You can go to Bogomolets when the above universities are shut, but having the better ones available, I don't think it makes sense to choose that. Okay, but if you still want to go ahead with it, you can definitely let us know, and we shall definitely guide you ahead. Okay, tell me about CSMU in Russia. Can you please type the full form of CSMU Ravi? That will be great. Aditi Patil, please tell me about USA package. USA, so now coming to US, there are two ways of doing your MBBS in US, okay? One way, if you want to get directly inside US, you have to give an exam called MCAT. Now, MCAT is one of the most difficult exams in the world, and it takes approximately 1 to 2 years for Indian students to, actually study for it and appear and really get good scores. Apart from that, you need to have a budget of approximately 2 to 3 crores, which is very unaffordable for most of the people in India. So that is the reason जो US की universities है उन्होंने एक offshore campus खोला है in the Caribbean. Now, Caribbean is on the outskirts of US, okay? So you should definitely look through that, because so the US MBBS system consists of three parts, okay, which is the pre-med, basic science, and clinical rotation. Now, you according to this roadmap, it is a right up to PG roadmap, okay. So you do your 3.5 years in the Caribbean, okay, and after that you go to the US for clinical rotation, and you complete your PG also over there only. So there are two options for the Caribbean roadmap. Your budget goes to approximately 80 lakhs, okay? And if you still want to do your PG from US but cannot afford a budget of 80 lakhs for MBBS, then what you can do is you can go for MBBS to a very good university in Russia or Ukraine, China, any of the good countries, and then you can prepare for USMLE. So we offer an online USMLE coaching. You can take that up for all the 6 years of your MBBS and prepare for USMLE and go to US for your PG at the end of the 6th year. Satish Soni, Ivano Frankivsk National Medical University, Ukraine field. Satish, you can also give me your contact details. So Ivano is also a good university. Okay, there are a lot of Indian students going there, but Vinnytsia would be a much better option because it's a better graded university. Okay, Satish, but if you still want to go for Ivano, you can let me know and we can definitely go about it. Okay, I can guide you further right up to PG. So feel free to share your contact details. Okay, Gunjan Kumari, what about University of Manchester? Gunjan, there's one thing that you need to understand is not all countries are meant for medical. Now, medical is such a field that it needs an immense amount of medical teaching experience which most of the countries do not have. For example, Nepal or countries like Georgia. I mean, they are so small, underdeveloped that they do not have the medical teaching facility, the experience that you really need. So choose a country where there, I mean, choose a university and a country where there are more number of Indian students going, where there have a lot of students been passed, had a good experience. Okay. Otherwise, for example, agar koi nahi school kholti hai, to pehle jo do teen batch hote hai, wo hamesha experimental batch hote hai. Jo bhi experiment hone hai system related, wo sare un batchon pe hote hai. So make sure that the university you're going to, it's well established. Okay. So Gunjan, that's not a right choice. Okay. Next question is by Brijesh Kumar. My NEET score is 250 and 12th score as follows. What to choose, Russia or China? Unfortunately, even in China, 90% of the universities have closed. Okay. Now, the ones which are remaining are very, very few. So, you have a very good NEET score as well as your PCB score, Mr. Kumar. So, I think you can choose either Russia or China. Okay. But it depends on where you want to do your PG from. So, basically, if you want to go for, say, Russia, you need to decide whether it's MBBS in Russia plus PG where. So you need to have that combo ready. Okay. It has to be MBBS in Russia plus PG in India or PG in USA or PG in Australia or PG in Germany. So that's the thing you need to decide upon. As far as for MBBS it's concerned, both are very good, just that a lot of universities in China have shut, so you have less options. So that way, Russia still has more options available right now. Bogomil, it's not about the problems, Mr. Hussain. It's actually about the grade of the university. Just that, ek jagah pe aapko agar koi achhi cheez mil rahi hai, available hai, to aap usse niche wali mein nahi jaoge. Whereas if that is not available, then you can compromise and go down. But I think right now you are, I mean, you are still very late, but you still have a chance to get into a better place. What about Lviv Medical University? Lviv is unfortunately closed. As I told you, all the seats are over since it's the extreme top university of Ukraine. Okay, it is booked complete. The booking starts right from March onwards and it's shut a month ago. So Lviv is closed. The next question, PCB 73%, can I get admission? Yes, I think you asked me this question already, Mr. Rakim. Prathamesh, what about Lady Fat? Prathamesh, that's what I told you. It is not about the college. It is about the country when it comes to Philippines. If you read the Indian, what the Indian embassy has to say, that the rules of the country itself is the problem. Now, whichever university you go, you have to do 2 years of BS. You have to give NMAT exam. I mean, it gets very lengthy. And once what happens is, 2 years ke baad agar aapko nahi milta hai, so it becomes a demotivating factor. Okay, you lose interest, you become demotivated. So try to get a straightforward roadmap. Try to, you know, make your take your career as a project that you have to work on. Okay, so don't, there's no point of taking such a kind of risk where you don't know. Please tell me about the Russian universities. I already told you, Crimea is available for the next 4 to 5 days, which is the top one of Russia. Okay, apart from that, there's Dagestan, there's Ryazan is closed now. So there are only two good options available in Russia right now. Otherwise, there are more options, but they are all low grade universities like Tver or, you know, Kazan and all of these. They are bilingual and they're a lower grade university. So they will be available even in August. So try to choose the better ones. How about Asian Medical College in Kyrgyzstan? It's a good choice if you have a fixed budget, Kumar. Humaya, I want to do my MBBS in Russia. Please suggest me which university. It depends on your budget. So Russia, for the budget for Russia would be basically between 20 to 25 lakhs, which includes your tuition fee, your accommodation, your food, your day-to-day expenses, your other charges, your, you know, visa tickets, A to Z, basically everything, your MCI coaching, all of that. So that's a Russia is a good option, Humaya, but pick up the good university because it won't be remaining for any longer. So please pick it up very, very fast. European countries or Asian countries, which one is better for MBBS? Jyoti, it's not about the country, it is about the university. I'm stressing on this point again and again so that all of you are very clear that you do not come in what a lot of people are trying to wrongly promote, okay? Because I mean, it's important for you to think about your career, your future prospects more than anything else. If you go to a wrong university for MBBS, your entire future is affected. So please take the right decision because it's a very sensitive issue. I mean, it's not as easy as people make it sound ki यहाँ पे चले जाओ, जॉर्जिया में चले जाओ, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, ओके? देर आर पीपल हु विल इवन शो यू द हॉस्टल पिक्चर्स एंड वीडियोस एंड यू नो मेक यू स्पीक टू अ फ्यू स्टूडेंट्स, बट यू नेवर नो व्हाट द रियलिटी एंड व्हाट द फैक्ट्स आर. सो प्लीज मेक श्योर दैट द यूनिवर्सिटी इज यू नो प्रूव्ड गुड with on an authentic source like a government report or an ad embassy advisory or something like that. Okay. Elaborate more about Germany. Ayushi, MBBS in Germany is not highly suggested because it's a very lengthy roadmap. Okay, it takes you approximately 8 to 8.5 years just for MBBS. So that's pretty long. Okay. So I'll request you, I mean, it's better if you go for MBBS to another country in a good top university and prepare for your German language, your entrance, and go to Germany for PG. So we have a lot of batches in the month of October and November of Indian doctors who we place for PG in Germany. So there are a lot of doctors who are going to Germany, but very few at an MBBS level because it's not highly advisable. Is Smolensk State Medical University Russia best for MBBS? No, that's not right, Mayur, because Smolensk again, there's no problem with the university, but there were approximately 150 students who came back from Smolensk. Okay, they have a lot of ragging and bullying and a lot of internal issues going on in Smolensk, so it's not a very good choice. So, I mean, you have better choices available, so go for them. Ukraine, Russia or Kazakhstan? Russia or Ukraine is a better option in compared to Kazakhstan, because they are both much developed countries in compared to Kazakhstan. Okay. Can we do PG after Russia MBBS in India with normal category competition? Yes, you can, provided you have studied for your next exam, you have taken the preparation with you and studied for it right up to 5 years of your MBBS. So make sure you've done that. How is Vinnytsia National University? Vinnytsia is very good, Sneha. There's no problem. I mean, after Lviv, it's the next best university in Ukraine. But which country would be a right choice? Among the choices available right now, without wasting much time, I think Russia and Ukraine are the better choices. China would be an amazing choice, but unfortunately, because we are a little late now. Lot of good universities in China are already shut, and very few are still remaining. So you don't have much choice. Is there an entrance test for PG in Russia? You cannot do your PG in Russia, Gunjan, because PG is done in a country where there is population, there is patient inflow. Now, the European countries do not have enough population because of which they do not have enough patients. And when there's no patient inflow, a doctor doesn't get a job. And if you see the conversion rate from INR to ruble, which is the Russian currency, you will know that even if you even if you, you know, get a job and you're doing it over there, you're earning much lesser than what you would earn in India. So PG in Russia doesn't make any sense. When you're going for MBBS, there are different considerations. But when you're going for PG, there are completely different considerations. But if you're going for PG, it's either US or it's coming back to India or it's going to Germany where there is a demand for your job. I mean, where there are a lot of opportunities, where there are specializations, patient inflow, all of that. What about Kyrgyzstan University preparation of MCI? MCI preparation is not by the university, okay? It follows that roadmap, but it doesn't take special efforts, Moreshwar. I think I've already spoken on this point. You need to take your MCI preparation along with you. I want to know about scholarship tests conducted. Jada, we do have a scholarship test conducted every year, but I'm not sure if we would be having it this year. But I'll definitely update you on that, okay? I cannot see Tambov University in your website. Because Harris, we are not among the consultancies or, you know, who are promoting a particular university for their benefit. Now, for example, an agent would promote XYZ University because he would be getting paid from that university, okay? But in our case, we purely follow the government report, okay? And there is no specific university that we have to promote. So, and the universities which are on our website has to be among the good universities available. If the universities, we know that, you know, it's not going to make a student's career, we do not put up on our website. Ayush, Laviv admissions closed now. Is it what you told, ma'am? Laviv admissions are closed, but there are last one or two seats available at the most. But overall, yes, it is closed because all the seats are over in Laviv. Rituja, Penza State University is 100 according to 100% English medium. Which country are you talking about, Rituja? Humaya, what about Kyrgyz State Medical Academy? That's a good choice, Humaya. But if you have an option, then you can go for Crimea in Russia because the cost is more or less the same. But Russia being a much developed country, having a better medical teaching experience, you would have a better exposure in Russia. But Kyrgyzstan, if you're going for it, it's okay. But otherwise, it's a little underdeveloped country. Okay, so you cannot have much expectations. Okay, you're talking about Crimea State Medical University, Ravi. Okay, so Crimea is basically that part of Ukraine which was taken over by Russia. Okay, now all these countries, say Georgia, Kyrgyzstan, they were earlier a part of Russia and now they are independent countries, Ravi. So if you see the report, the university mentioned in Ukraine is Crimea Medical University, and which is mentioned in Russia is Crimea State Medical University. Okay, so they are two different. And also Crimea State Medical University, which is in Russia, is now earlier it was state funded and now it is national funded. So now the new name is Crimean Federal University. So that is the one which has a good ratio and, you know, Indian food, maximum Indian students, high quality of education, high grading, and like the top university of Russia. So it's the Crimea State Medical University, or you can call it the Crimean Federal University, Ravi. So do not get confused with that. MBBS from Bangladesh, I mean, if you want to go for it, it's okay, but it's not much of a recommended choice considering the safety and security over there. After studying in Crimea, can I pursue PG in US? No, you cannot, because the situation is that Ukraine says that Crimea belongs to them, whereas Russia says, and Russia has rather already taken over. But US doesn't want to get into that controversy, so it doesn't recognize Crimea itself. So if you're thinking about PG in US, then Crimea is not an option for you. You can choose Dagestan, or you can choose Lviv is also close. You can choose Vinnytsia. I mean, you need to choose another top university if you're planning for PG in US. But what happens is, if you say that you want to go for PG in Australia, then you can go to Crimea because USMLE is accepted in Australia as well. So just in case you do not get the required qualification marks for USMLE Step 1 and you do not end up getting into US for PG, Australia is still an option. So if you are thinking about that, then Mr. Kumar, that's a good option. Yes, Ravi, I explained that to you already. Mayank, Nepal is not that good an option because it's pretty expensive. It starts with 50 lakhs because the living cost is very high. Plus, it's not much of a developed country, so it doesn't have the exposure that you would need during your internships and your your hospital visits and all of that. Sneha Mishra, how will I get books for MCI preparation in Ukraine? You do not get books. We have a completely online preparation for MCI screening test, Sneha. So you can take that portal. It has a user ID and a password, and we give that portal to you. You can take it and you can access it as per your flexibility and convenience and study MCI little by little every day, okay, for all the 6 years. Umer, if we go for say a 14 lakh package for 6 years in Russia, they say it includes academic fees plus hostel. There remains only fooding, but it is said that later we are made to pay many more expenses on one account or the other. That does happen, Umair. If you go, I mean, if you go to a university or if you go through a consultant which is not transparent and honest about the real costs, then this is the problem that you face. Okay. Now, when you go for abroad education, you need to understand that apart from your tuition fee and apart from your hostel and food, there are a lot of small costs that people do not count. I mean, even if every year in the vacation you come to India and go back, that's also going to cost. Nobody, talks about that. So when they say that the budget is 20 lakhs, I mean 25 lakhs is something you need to consider, okay? And if you have a very fixed budget, then you go to a university which is of a much lower cost than your real budget, okay? So please keep that in mind. Also choose a consultancy which is transparent to you about it, okay? Because you need their support right up to 6 years. It's not just about 1 year, okay? And in our case, we support our students right up to 9 years because none of our students go for MBBS without taking PG preparation along with them. So we just do not have an MBBS program. We have MBBS plus PG, a combo program. Okay, so that's something you need to completely look at. What about Orenburg State Medical University? That's a bilingual university, Ganendra Kumar. Okay, so not a good option. Sachin, is there more chance of ragging in abroad? It's about the university. Now, as I told you, Smalling's has those issues, but other universities are completely safe. There is no problem whatsoever. Okay, I want to know about Tambov and Smalling State Medical. Harris, both of these universities are a bad choice. Smalling's because of the issues that they have over there, and Tambov because of the MCI passing ratio. So I think there are many better universities available, Harris. This is the Indian Embassy in Russia official website, Harris. You can check it out over there. Ravi, what is the total budget of Crimea? The total budget is around, say, 20 lakhs, because 15 lakhs is for your tuition fee, accommodation, and other university charges, plus your tickets, visa, food, your other expenses, your travel to India and back for all 6 years, all those expenses, you count around 20 lakhs. Your MCI online preparation and all of that. Is Kharkiv Medical University in Ukraine better option for MBBS? No, that's not right. Because if you see the MCI passing ratio of Kharkiv, you will know what I'm talking about. Okay, just see if you can see. Now, these are the universities which are recommended by the embassy. Recommended in the sense, these are the universities where most of the students go every year. Okay. But if you still wish to go to Kharkiv, then I can definitely... we can talk about it and we can place you there. It's completely possible, but Vinnytsia is a much better choice than Kharkiv. Okay, so if you have a better one available, go for that. Karendra, you have a lot of options. You have Crimea, you have Vinnytsia, you have Bogomolets, you have a lot of options, Karendra. Okay, so please go through the report, choose a university with a good ratio. Okay, that's all I can tell you. Kazan Federal is a bilingual university, not a good choice, a very, very low grade university. So many Indian students, but a few students appear from MB test. Why? That is because there are a lot of students who come back from Bogomolets also. There are a lot of students who do not settle down that easily, and there are a lot of students who do not want to come back to India. So the MCI test is given by students who want to do their PG in India, who want to practice in India. Okay, Sanjeev. So there are a lot of students in Bogomolets, but I mean, you can go to Bogomolets provided there is no better one available. But if you still want to go there and you know about the pros and cons, then I can definitely place you there and I can make sure that everything is, you know, right. MBBS in Russia plus PG in USA. Yes, definitely. Mr. Kumar, please share your contact details with me and my expert team of expert counselors. They'll definitely give you a call. They'll give you a call tomorrow or on Monday and they'll explain the entire program to you. Okay. Umair, 2018-319. Umair, there are a lot of options available. Okay, you can go for Crimea. It's the best one in Russia available right now. Okay. You can go for MBBS in Crimea plus PG in Australia. Okay. You can go for MBBS in Vinnytsia plus PG in USA or MBBS in Dagestan plus PG in USA. There are a lot of options available, Umair. But the good options are very few and they are all there for a very short period of time. So please take that decision very fast or you might lose out on the good options. Do all China university give an internship in India? What's the procedure of taking admission there? Yes, there are some universities who do that. One of the good universities open right now is Jiangsu Medical University that requires a NEET score of above 260, Gunjan. So if you're interested for that, there are applications open for the next few days for Jiangsu. So you can apply for that. Prathamesh, as I told you, MBBS in Germany is not much of a preferred option. Moreshwar Dole, Jalalabad University, MCI cleared. Jalalabad, you can check on the report, but it's not a good choice for sure. Okay, there are many, many better universities available. Umaya, you can go for Vinnytsia. MBBS in Vinnytsia plus PG in USA or PG in Germany or PG in India. That will be the best choice for you, okay? Or you can go for MBBS in Crimea, okay? Or Dagestan or Rezan, but Rezan is again closed. So all the good options, the few options are available right now. Ganendra, Orenburg State Medical University is the worst choice you could make because it is bilingual, okay? And you will realize this after 3 years of your education, and by the time you realize this, it will be too late, okay? So the MCI does not recommend that at all. Prathamesh, as I told you, there is Crimea available, there's Vinitsa available, there's Dagestan available, there are another few universities like Nizhny or Rostov or Uzhgorod in Ukraine. There are a lot of universities available, but the ones from on the report which are of the top grade, there are very, very few. There's Crimea, there's Dagestan, and there's Vinitsa. These are the top ones available in Russia and Ukraine as of date, which will be shut in a few days again. Poland is not a much recommended choice, not at all, because it has a budget of around 50 lakhs because of the living cost, but the quality of education is not that great. Aditi, for after Ayurveda BMS, can we go abroad for PG? You can go, okay, but you'll have to do your research on which countries is the right place. Sneha, whether next exam includes the PG test or not, that nobody knows. The MCI hasn't called for it right now, but there are very, very high chances that there will be only one single exam, and all the students, whether they are in India or they have come from abroad after MBBS, they all have to give that exam. Okay, so next will qualify you for NEET PG as well. There are very high chances of that coming up. Jyoti, the budget for China or Ukraine, both will be around 30 lakhs. Including everything, and by everything I mentioned all the small costs also. Kazan Federal, not a good choice because it is bilingual, low MCI passing ratio, low quality. Jasraj is Crimea. It is completely safe. There are more than 500 students who are Indian students who are studying in Crimea. Okay, since the past many years, they have Indian food. They have all the facilities that you need. Okay, they have an amazing faculty. They have a 40% MCI passing ratio. They have a very good hostel facility. So, Jasraj, safety is not a problem. Crimea is a very good choice. Okay, the MCI definitely recommends that. Humaya Osh is a second grade university. Kyrgyz State Medical Academy is the top one in Kyrgyzstan. Okay. But I would suggest you that you should choose a more developed country if you can stretch your budget up to 20 lakhs, okay? You're welcome, Sneha. Vinitsa is much preferable, Sanjeev. You do not need to think about patience when it comes to MBBS, because what happens is the patient inflow part comes into the picture during PG, and your PG will be good only if your MBBS is good. Okay, so Vinitsa has a much better quality of education, so you will set up a better foundation for your PG rather than Bogomolets. But if you still want to go ahead with Bogomolets, we can place you there definitely. Language is a problem. It depends on how you take it. Now, if you're going to a new place, aapko thoda time lagega to adjust to the new language. Now, even the programs which are 100% English medium, okay, in all the countries, you have to learn their local language as a subject. Kyunki aapko wahan pe 6 saal rehna hai. आप बाहर जाओगे, if you go to buy something, if you go for your internship here and there, you will have to speak that language, you will have to communicate it on a daily basis. So learning that language is very important, but doing your medical curriculum in that language is foolishness. Garendra, I already answered your question. No, you cannot come without screening test to India, Aditi, until and unless you have done your PG from the US. Mayank, you can go for Jiangsu in China if you have a budget of around 30 lakhs and if you have a NEET score of 260 and above. Satish, Lavi would have been the best choice, but unfortunately you are a little late. So Vinitsa is the next best, and if you further make it late, you will have to choose something below Vinitsa also. Humaya, does not Iran universities does not make sense at all. Zhejiang University in China is a very good option, Mayur. Definitely a very, very good option. Jyoti, if you do your MBBS from Russia or Ukraine or China and do your PG from US, then you do not need to appear for the MCI screening test. And that rule is available on the MCI official website. What is the cost of PG in India? Now, the cost of PG, it's a very good question, Ravi. So the cost of PG is basically the cost of preparation to get into PG. जब आप PG में जाते हो तब आप पैसे कमाते हो, whether it's in India or abroad. But the only difference is in India you have already given so much of donation that the money that you earn holds no value. So whereas that's not the case outside. Okay, now if you go to US, your minimum package while you are doing your PG starts from around 30 to 40 lakhs. So I mean, by the time you've not even completed your PG, you've already earned back double than what you spent on your PG. So Ravi, if you're thinking about PG in India, MCI screening test preparation has to be taken along with you. The online preparation, you have to prepare for it dedicatedly for 6 years and then appear for PG and then go for PG in India. Sachin, it's not very expensive. If you just give me your contact details, I'll share the MCI online study material costs with you. No, Anne, you do not have the provision of MCI eligibility certificate. It's not required anymore as per the latest rules of the MCI. Okay. Prathamesh, Creamia is 100% English medium. Vinitsa is 100% among the ones available. I'm saying Vinitsa is the 100% English medium. Dagestan is 100% English medium. So these are the 300% English medium options available right now. Apart from that, there's Nizhny and Rostov. These are a little bit of a new universities which are not there on the report, but there are a lot of students going there. Ravi, compare Vinitsa versus CSMU. So if you're thinking about the PG in US, then go for Vinitsa, Ravi. But if you're thinking about PG back in India, then go for Creamia. So it depends on your PG destination, which university to choose. Considering both MBBS and PG, which available university should I prefer, which is safe as well? Sanjeev, as I told you, among the top three ones available right now, these are all going to be closed in the next coming week. So, I mean, there are daily lot of applications coming in for these universities, and I myself don't know when these will be over because we get applications from right across India, from different parts of the country. So make sure you're fast to apply, otherwise you might lose out on the good seat. Prathamesh, Creamia requires 70% in chemistry and bio. So because it's at most top university of Russia, so you will not get it in 67%, Prathamesh. Go for Vinitsa. That's a better option for you. Mureshwar, Kyrgyzstan. I mean, you rather go to Crimea because there is not much difference in the cost, but the quality of education differs on a very, very huge scale. Jasraj Singh, MBBS in Crimea plus PG in Germany. Perfect choice, Jasraj. Go for it. Shivam, there are very few universities in China. There's Jiangsu available, there's Zhejiang available, there's Kunming and Qingdao available, but very, very few, so not much variety. Okay, if you can just give me your contact details, Shivam, my counselor will give you all the information on China. Yes, Ganendra, you are not allowed to go for PG in US if you do your MBBS from Creamia. Okay, but you can do your PG in India, you can do your PG in Germany, and you can do your PG in Australia, New Zealand, everywhere. So if US is something you want to do your PG for, then go for Vinitsa, Prathamesh, Ukraine or Russia. As I told you again, it's not about the country, it is about the university. If it's Ukraine, it has to be Lviv, it has to be Vinitsa, it has to be the top one. If it's Russia, it has to be Crimea, it has to be Dagestan, again, has to be the top one. So that's completely up to you. Mureshwar, this is the Indian Embassy in Russia education section that I showed you the report on. Aditi, we directly go to USA for PG without any exam after MBBS in Russian Good University. No, you have to appear for an exam called the USMLE exam. Okay, you cannot enter PG in US without that exam. Okay, just excuse me for a second. You can do your MBBS in Russia, which will have around 5.8 years. Plus, you will be preparing for your USMLE during those 5.8 years and directly go for US. So you can consider a total of around 8.5 to 9 years, Aditi. Ganendra, if you are sure that Russia is the option, then go for Dagestan. Okay, Dagestan plus PG in USA is the good choice, Ganendra, if it's Russia. Or else you can go for Vinitsa plus PG in USA. Ravi, I have 91 in PCB. How much chance in Crimea State Medical? You have a full chance, Ravi. You are more than qualified for Crimea. So, but unfortunately, the seats are very less. So apply as soon as possible, and I'm sure you will get into it. So Crimea, you can easily get into, Ravi. Not a problem. Brijesh Kumar, after doing your P, completing your MBBS in Vinitsa, so what you can do is just share your contact details so that my counselor can share the cost sheets with you and clearly explain everything to you. Yes, I will be preparing you for USMLE. There's a whole portal, okay, which will be given to you. Yes, it is, Prathamesh. Yes, it is. Thank you, Mr. Brijesh Kumar, for sharing your contact details. My counselor shall definitely give you a call tomorrow. Okay. So I think we will be ending today's session now. It was great to have all of you. It was a very interactive and a very nice session. I had a lot of questions. I hope I've cleared a lot of doubts which all of you would be having. Okay, Ganendra, please share your contact details. My counselors will give you the cost sheet for USMLE. Okay. So, thank you so much, Ravi. Good night to you too. And I shall see you all again on Monday. Yes, thank you, Aditi Patil, for your contact number. Humaya, thank you so much for your contact number as well. And so, there's one more thing that I would like to tell you, Aditi, that if you want to do your PG from US, I mean, if you do want to go for the MBBS plus PG program, make sure that the university that you're going to is a Com HP approved university. Otherwise, you are in deep trouble, okay? So, Spartan Health and Science is a very good option because it has the highest USMLE passing ratio. So, Aditi, I have your contact details, I think. Yes. So, my counselor will call you and give you all the information. Yes, thank you, Harris. I got your contact details as well. Prathamesh, Vinitsa MBBS plus USPG. Perfect, Prathamesh. You've got your choice right. Okay, thank you so much, all of you. See you all again on Monday. Okay, and keep coming up with all the inquiries that you have, all the doubts that you have. Okay, yes, you can do that, Mayank. Yes, you definitely can do that. Go ahead. Yes, so I would request all of you to keep coming in on every Monday to Saturday, 7 to 8 p.m. We would be having our counseling sessions. You can visit our YouTube channel, okay, which is Moksh Webinars. You'll have a lot of such content over there that will definitely help you to guide help and guide you further. Okay. How to register for all these colleges. Prathamesh, to register for this, tomorrow my counselor will give you a call, and I have already forwarded your details, okay? And you'll definitely get a call tomorrow, and they'll help you with the whole registration process. Thank you, Rutuja. I got your email ID, your contact number as well. And okay, Humaya, put my question. What question are you talking about? Okay, email ID. Thank you. Thank you, Harris. Around 30 lakhs, Aditi. Not a good choice, Annie. It is a Chinese medium program. Thank you, Pratamesh. Thank you so much. Thank you all for your details and for the amazing enthusiasm. It was a very good experience to have all of you. And tomorrow you shall get a call, tomorrow and day after, okay? So stay tuned and you shall get many, many more such counseling sessions every day. Okay, thank you and good night to all of you. Humaya, okay, before I just got two last questions. Humaya, you can go for Vinitsa plus PG in USA with a budget of 30 lakhs. Or you can go for Crimea plus PG in Germany. That's another good option. Yes, Rutuja, you have one last question. Please put it up. Okay, I think there is some technique. No, it is not, Rutuja. It is not. Okay, taking a leave now. Thank you all of you again and good night.